good evening everyone and welcome back. Welcome to another Fortnight, which unfortunately starts with the left foot, not with the right, how it should. It's 10 p.m. and I'm just departing the depot. Why so late? Well, because I got let down again by the team. When I came Friday night, I filled up a vehicle defect notice for two tires having some metal bits in it and being soft, having punctures. That was Friday afternoon when I got back from the previous fortnight, previous trip. Today is Tuesday and nothing got done. So when I came today, the tires were down all the way, so I had to call the after hour service. They got Bridgestone involved, and fair enough, took 4 hours by the time Bridgestone came. They first assessed the problem, went back, picked up 2 new tires, came back, changed them. So yeah, this is how you can lose 4 hours. And now finally on a way to Wheatstone Onslow on the coastal drive. Well, how I said, starting the fortnight with the left foot. Fuel, and then on the way to Geraldton. Alright, so topped up with 620 liters of diesel. Now, having a full tanks of diesel, full tanks of AdBlue, everything, AdBlue will be enough to get there back and into Newman and back. Diesel will be enough to get to Carnarvon, where probably I'll need to top up with another 600 liters, and that will be enough to get to Wheatstone, Onslow, back to Carnarvon, top up again and come to Perth. When I get here, be the usual thing, change trailers and head up to Newman for Warrawando. Let's hope that won't be any more surprises. This will be the last one that I had tonight, and the rest of the trip will go well, but it's hard to say, it's hard to tell. You don't know what's on the road. It's 1300 kilometers to Dea, 13 and a half back to depot, so it's lots of things can happen. But anyway, tonight I'll be more than happy. I can make it to that parking bay just before Geraldton, like I did 2 weeks ago, and camp there for the night. It's already 11:20, so yeah. Let's see how far I can go until 2 o'clock. It's one of that trips again where another colleague will be waiting for me in Carnarvon to drop his trailer there, but not much I can do about it. Not my fault that they can't do the right thing in a depot. I done my bit, I filled up the VDR from Friday afternoon till today, Tuesday afternoon. They had enough time to look at that two blurry tires. Oh, yeah. It is what it is. I'm not gonna go out of my way to push myself to the max to stuff up, to fix up their stuff ups. I do what I can. When I feel tired, I feel tired. I just stop. End of story. And the road, it's quite busy too tonight. So until I pass Kataby, will be like this. Because there are the tankers that pick up water from Jinjin, then tippers from Kataby with the natural sand, the zirconia sand, or glass sand, how some people call it. And a lot of small vehicles too. Once I will pass, that will be a bit more quiet, but till then it's quite busy on the road too. So to make the life even harder, we're having rain too. Looks like I just missed the big one, but yeah, it's still drizzling. Probably one of these trees got his name on it. Breakdown truck. Poor bastard. I know very well how it is to get breakdown. I had enough of them. Well, that's all for tonight. Let's see if I can fit in here. Not really, because these guys looks like they are biking. So unfortunately I have to take 20 minutes break and then go on the other side of the town. Go a bit further up in the parking and yeah, why the other guy didn't come closer to this one, I don't know. So, yeah, well, what can you do? Right, so after a 20 minutes break, I can drive again. So legally, I'm good for another 5 hours. But that's not gonna happen. I just wanna go on the other side of Geraldton and park there for the night. I was looking forward to this parking here, but yeah, the way the other two parked, putting the distance between them, I had no room in the front of them, I had no room behind them. So yeah, unfortunately it's one of the things that can happen. Okay, let's see what this parking bay has to offer. This one, it's empty. Well, it's already 4 o'clock in the morning, and that's enough for me. More than I was planning to, but since I couldn't stop there, yeah. Excuse me, this will do. So good night, guys, and I'll see you in the morning. Morning, guys, and welcome back. So it is 11 a.m. after my 7 hours break. Just getting everything ready, making myself a coffee, get some breakfast, and heading towards Carnarvon. Yeah, it's one of that days today. I mean, I feel sorry for the guy that is doing a Ramara run, because I got one of his riders. Unfortunately, there's not much I can do about it. If my truck was ready, I wouldn't have to wait for Bristol last night to come and fix it and waste 4 hours in a depot. It'd be a different story, but yes. Unfortunately, there's nothing I can do about it. It is what it is. I'm not happy either, because I'm so late. Alright. Anything, need to start up the engine, otherwise the inverter will stop working shortly after turning on the machine. Thank you. funny how you sit in a truck and you see the cab from different angles. I mean, sitting there, you look, you see dust, you clean up, then you sit in a truck and look from a different angle and it's more dust, which you can't see it from there. Always fighting the bloody thing to stay out of the cab. Let's go. So let's go. So I should be in Carnarvon by 3:30, 4 o'clock, if everything goes all right. Quite a bit of rain last night, and yeah, just have a look how quick everything dried up. It's like never rain. It's all dry. Yeah, it's 1:15 and I'm just driving through Billabong now. managed to get in contact with the driver from Carnarvon, the one which is waiting for his third trailer, the one I'm taking there, and he's all cool with my arrival time at 4 o'clock. He's doing other stuff. He's just going to fill up, having his break, lunch, bit of rest, and when I get there, he'll just hook up and go up the road to Eramara. In Carnarvon as well, and then top up, so that mean 5:30 leaving from Carnarvon. Will will get me probably 10:30, 11 o'clock tonight in Wheatstone. Usually, if I have a good run, I will do it in 5 hours from Carnarvon to Wheatstone. But something happened, or I have to do a couple of stops on a white, then I'll have to take another 20 minutes break somewhere, and that will push me to 11:30 in Wheatstone. We'll see what happens, we'll see how we go. So far, since I left from Northampton this morning, I was having a good run. Well, it's only 2 hours, but yeah. This week is a bit more cool outside, it's not that hot. Like today, it's only 31 degrees. slowly I'm getting to Wormhole. Picking up a bit. Now on 15 to Carnarvon. So about 3:45, yeah. Thing is, I'm getting headwinds now. And it looks like that is wiping off a couple of k's from my speed. Yeah, I had to do a couple of stops. On the way. Because it's so windy. It doesn't take long for that buckles on a tow liner to become loose. And I hate to see them flapping in the wind. So as soon as that happened, first parking bay, stopping in, tidying them up. But yeah, when on one side the wind is pushing the curtains against the gate, and on the other side is like a parachute, things like this happen. Doesn't matter how tight you do them, for all that movement that the wind is creating, all that flapping, sooner or later they come loose and they come undone. So yeah, unfortunately it is one of the things that you can't control. Have to live with it. Anyway, minutes and I'll be in the Rotterdam area, dropping the last trailer, then dropping mine, pick up the other one as a lead, and heading to BP. See the Rotterdam assembly area from here. Okay. I can see my colleague here waiting for his trailer. And I'll be dropping it right behind him. so this is one of that stuffed up one. One that lost its spring. Alright. Open it. Rotary. Now. This is gonna be my lead, so. Okay, good. I'll check inside after hooking up. Wheels look okay on this side. They look okay on this side. Good. Okay, so ready to go. Okay.
again, Mikhail takes. Oh, yeah.
Okay, that browser is not working on my side, so I'm doing a bit of a changing. That's better. After having something to eat and filling up, make my way to Wheatstone. Get closer, don't really know what's there. I can see now, because I have a bit of a clear picture of what's going on, it is dust, it's not a bushfire, so that's good, at least. My left. big dust cloud. At least there's no fires, no danger. Of course, I'm not happy with the dust either, because it's getting inside and creating an extra work for me to clean her up, but looks of it, it's for kilometers and kilometers, all that coastal area is just a big ball of dust. On both sides of the road. So it's like a big blanket of fog. Even the sun disappeared. Finally out of it. Officially, we are passing the Tropic of Capricorn. Straight line to my right, and you get into Capricornia Roadhouse. feel the smell of dust inside of the cabin. It's coming through the aircon vents. Slow road from here, another 45 minutes, and I'll be in Wheatstone. It's 9 p.m. 9:45. Beautiful done. The good news is that this week is not that hot like last week, so it's gonna be a bit better tomorrow. And I was hoping to have a weather like this, because I got a really ugly load in the tow liner. Up in, on the mess decks, I got some long 8-meter links of steel and stuff like that, and it will be just so awkward to unload it, and that will be a bit of a time consuming, and sitting out in the sun when it's 43 is not fun. At least it will be a bit more mild tomorrow. all dusty around here. Everything is covered in a big ball of dust. Like a fog. Trucks. So we are at Wheatstone.
The coffee in the morning.
special lid, so when I need to use the machine, I can put it here instead of putting it in the top of the bridge. So yeah, I don't know, not really hungry. I'll just have a cup of tea and go to bed. So see you guys in the morning. Till then, you take care and be safe out there. We'll see what happens tomorrow. So good night, everyone.